Hey YouTube, iPadXMobile2 here. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how you can get Apple CarPlay in any car you want for just $3. This is very simple and it doesn't require you to buy a new head unit for your car or anything. What this is basically an app you can get on your iPhone, iPod Touch, iPad, whatever, that will run and it'll give you the exact same UI as Apple CarPlay. Now, it's not exactly the same as, and it's not the version that Apple made, but it's completely remade to look exactly like it and work exactly like it. And this version actually has some additional features which the original Apple CarPlay doesn't have, so it actually has some benefits over the original. But this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to show you first of all how to get it on a jailbroken and a non-jailbroken device, then I'll show you what exactly it does and how it works. So to start with, we'll show you how to put it on a jailbroken device. It's very simple. All you have to do is go to Cydia and search for CarPlay iOS. It should be the only thing that shows up. Just install that and you can try it out for a week, and then you have to pay for the after the trial's over, you have to pay $3 for each device you want to put it on. But it's very cheap and it's definitely worth it in my opinion if you want to use CarPlay. But if you want to get it on a non-jailbroken device, it's a little bit more complicated. You do need to have a Mac operating system ready. Don't worry if you don't actually have a Mac. I'll link my video on how to install Mac on a virtual machine in the description below, so you can actually run it on Windows and you can do it that way. But if you have a Mac, you can just do it very simply. You're going to need a few things. You're going to need to download the iOS App Signer from the link in the description below. You're also going to need to download the CarPlay iOS app dev file. So you can get both of these from these websites. So iOS App Signer, you can get it from here. Just click on the little download button down here, and then for Apple CarPlay iOS, you're going to get it the dev file from tweakupdates.com, which I'll just put a link to this page in the description below. You just click on the latest version here, but that's how you download those, and I've got both of those already on my desktop. You're also going to need to download Xcode from the Mac App Store. Don't worry, this is free. And the last thing you're going to need to do is have your Apple ID linked to the developer portal. And you do not need to have the developer program, the paid ones. All you need to do is go to developer.apple.com, sign in with your Apple ID and register, and then you should get a profile there so you can actually use that with Xcode. So then once you've got that all done, open up Xcode, sign in with your Apple ID when it prompts you to, when you select the team, which I'll show you in a second. But it's very simple. All you need to do is create a new project in there. You can call it whatever you want. I'll just call it CarPlay iOS when this loads up. So as you can see in the Xcode launcher, just click on Create New Xcode Project. Then click on Single View Application and click Next. So you can call this whatever you want. I'm just going to call it CarPlay and that's it. Make sure you put an organization identifier in there, which is just com.yourusername or whatever. It really doesn't matter if it's not already there. But for me it is. And then just leave everything else as is and click Next. Then click Create, and then that's it. So then you need to actually see your team here. You should see your Apple ID in this drop down box. If it's not, you just need to log in with your Apple ID that's linked to your developer account, then this should show up. So select that and then click on the little button that says Fix Issue to fix any code signing issues there may be. And this is very simple, it should only take a few seconds, and that's done, it's fixed all the issues. Then just go up to the top here where it says iPhone 6s Plus or whichever simulator it says. Make sure you have your iOS device plugged in and click on that device in the top there. Then you can actually minimize Xcode for now, and you're going to need to use the iOS App Signer. So all you need to do in here is actually in the first box, just browse for your CarPlay dev file, which I've got here, so I'll just drag in. For the signing certificate, you should see iPhone developer, your Apple ID, and then the ID for that there. And then in the next box, provisional profiles, you're going to need to select the Xcode project you just made. So for me, it's com.iPadXM42.carplay. Select that and then just click start. And then choose where you want to save it. I'll just put it on the desktop. Desktop, if I can do it right. Click on save, and then it should actually export this file to an IPA file, which will be able to be installed through Xcode. So once that's done, you should get this on your desktop. You're going to need to go back into Xcode, go up to the top where it says Window, and then click on the Devices tab. Then you should see your iPhone that you plugged in here on this list. You're just going to want to click on the little plus button that's here under Installed Apps. Click on plus, find the IPA file you just made with the iOS App Signer, click on Open, and then it should install that on your iPhone. So once this is done, you can see it's now in an installed apps bit, and you should see CarPlay iOS on your iOS device, as you can see here. So as you can see, when you try to open it, it'll actually say Untrusted Developer. So all you need to do is go to Settings, go to General, go down until you see Device Management, Profiles, or Device Management, depending on what version of iOS 9 you're running. Tap on that, tap on your Apple ID, and then tap on Trust and Trust again, and then you're done, and you can go back out of there, and you should now be able to open the CarPlay iOS app, and that's all you have to do. So as you can see, you can actually do a lot with this. It looks exactly the same as what you would normally get on Apple CarPlay. As you can see, I've just got a car here that already has it built in, and I'll compare it to the actual app that I've got here as well. So as you can see, it looks the same. You've got all the same apps that work functionally, but you actually got some additions as well. You can actually add apps onto this, so you can actually have shortcuts to your iOS apps, like so. You can actually move these apps around as well, which you can't previously do. And things like that. You can swipe through pages, that's quite simple. You've also got the same home button type stuff at the side. You can actually open up music, you control music, looks exactly the same as it would on Apple CarPlay. You can do your maps, you can do your phone contacts, and you can actually just plug the aux cable from your phone to your car stereo if you want to actually have music or anything going to your car. That's pretty simple to do. Most cars actually have that. And yeah, so you've got a few other things as well. So you can actually have it so that if you have your device plugged in to your ignition or into your car, when you turn off the ignition, the power will cut to it. So at that point, your device will think, okay, power's cut, engine's off, I'm going to turn off my device. So it actually locks the device after that. You can actually turn that on or off. You can control whether you want to show the speed, weather, or just your battery percentage on the sidebar. You can change the sides on which the sidebar shows depending on which side of the car you are on. It's very, very customizable, and it's something that I think you should definitely try it out. You do get a week's free trial, so definitely try it out if you're interested. Works with any iOS device. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Like I said, if you need to install this, it's very simple. Just go back and do that. If you need a Mac, you can just use my virtual machine tutorial, which will be linked below. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Like the video if you liked it, leave a comment if you have any questions, and as always, don't forget to subscribe.